Coming up, dissecting Kansas City's moment on the national stage, the all-star highs and lows, and what's next now for Kansas City. Plus, remember the plaza building controversy? Is there about to be another one? As the Hyatt announces plans for a 12-story hotel along with millions in tax breaks at one of the most sought-after addresses in the city. Why are they still waiting and waiting and waiting in Kansas DMV offices? And introducing you to downtown's newest transit system, the bicycle. Hello again, I'm Nick Haynes, and it is great to have you once again on the program that goes beyond the soundbite and takes you behind the headlines, making news in Kansas City. Pouring over that news with us this week is one of the biggest names in Kansas City sports broadcasting, from 810 Sports Radio, WHB, Kevin Keatsman, from 41 Action News chief political reporter Chris Hernandez, from the Kansas City Star reporter, blogger and columnist Dave Helling, and Star Development writer and columnist Kevin Collison. Now, it was the biggest event in Kansas City in decades. 5 days of festivities as the Major League Baseball All-Star Game headed into town for the first time in 39 years. Now, city leaders claimed it would bring a $60 million boost to the local economy. Now that the national television camera crews have left and the hotels have emptied out, Kevin Keatsman, how did the city do?
You know what? I think the city did great. I think that there was a lot more effort here in Kansas City than there are in other cities who get a lot of events like this. I mean, last year it was in Phoenix, next year it's in New York. And, you know, you think about all the conventions and big events that are in places like Phoenix and New York. I don't think they try as hard. The word that we heard from everyone that we talked to, the ball players, the people in baseball, those that came to town from Major League Baseball and some of the companies, said they couldn't believe it. I mean, the number of police escorts and things like this, is it over the top? Is it all necessary? I don't know that it is, but a lot of people that came into town were blown away with how important this was to Kansas
City. Now, people are patting themselves on the back here, Chris, but out-of-towners too, the people from newspapers across the country were saying these things too?
Yeah, some of the people I talked with who were here, just in one day on the plaza, I ran into, you know, people from Ohio and New York and Pennsylvania, and I think that the whole Midwestern charm and friendliness of the city, I think definitely people got a sense of that and really appreciated it. Even with this whole controversy over the booing at the home run derby, it was kind of funny because people were like saying, oh, well, back east, we boo a heck of a lot more than that. Here, people are pretty friendly. So they didn't have as big a problem with that. And I think that the huge core of volunteers really made a difference.
Now, early on in this whole deal, there was concerns, of course, about we were not even geared up for this. Transportation was going to be a big issue, Dave Helling. Potentially, there may have been problems with rioting teenagers on the plaza. There weren't any of these big problems, were there?
No, Kansas City tends to do a pretty good job on a lot of events like this. We've had Final Fours here that have gone off fairly well. In 1985, the World Series was here. That went well. I think there is a lot of planning that goes into presenting an event like this that Kansas City understands. They spent a lot of money, taxpayer money, to get ready. So I think the city, in terms of its planning, acquitted itself quite well. And I think you see that it reflected in the lack of criticism of how this event was pulled off.
Last week we had Mayor Pro Tem Cindy Serco on the program saying the city spent about $2 million. Probably it may be upwards of that time we figure in the police costs and all of this. I mean, did the city get its money worth out of this deal, Kevin?
I think it probably got its money's worth as far as people visiting here. I think it got shortchanged from everything I hear about the Fox broadcast. We did an economic impact story a couple of days before the event. And the big payoff, according to a lot of these experts, was going to be the exposure the city would get to the rest of the nation and the world. I talked to people in St. Louis. They had like a two-minute montage of beautiful scenes in St. Louis that preceded the broadcast there 3 years ago. From what I understand, the Negro League Baseball Hall of Fame got some nice plugs from Fox at the beginning of the broadcast, but the rest of the city got a short shrug. And they really, a lot of folks in town went out of their way to highlight the buildings in blue and try to make the city look great. And we just did not get that kind of nice cutaway shots that would give people an idea Kansas City's a pretty cool place.
We were shortchanged on that, Kevin Keatsman?
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's a sports audience. I mean, Fox is running a business. They're trying to get high ratings. They did not succeed. This was the lowest rated All-Star game ever. And the reason was the game was no good. Five runs in the first inning, a lot of the national audience just tuned out and said, this is boring. So you can't control things like that. But, you know, I've been in television, I've been in radio. They know exactly who their audience is. They're into baseball. I think that's probably why they featured the Negro Leagues Museum. I don't think they were as concerned about maybe barbecue or fountains or the arts as they were about keeping the baseball audience watching so they could make a buck.
You mentioned the ratings, by the way. I was also intrigued by the fact that St. Louis had a higher rating than Kansas City. If the game was in Kansas City, why were ratings higher in St. Louis than Kansas City?
Those people are sick over there. I mean, they have nothing else but baseball. I mean, St. Louis and baseball, it's ridiculous. I mean, it's a little bit like college basketball is here. College basketball in Kansas City is a huge thing. And in other cities this size around the country, it's not nearly as big a deal. St. Louis is sort of the epicenter of baseball. They had seven players on the All-Star team. They were watching the Cardinals play.
Yes. Chris?
Well, I think definitely the tourism community really wanted to get that big plug at where you show beautiful shots of Kansas City. I mean, even the barbecue shots they showed, it was an unidentifiable barbecue pit. It could have been anywhere.
Yeah. So it's difficult to see.
I don't disagree with that. On the other hand, do people not know in the rest of the country we have barbecue in Kansas City? I mean, do you have to depend on a baseball broadcast
yes,
for people
we
to say, why, I had no idea you could get short end in Kansas City. Of course people know that. I think a lot of that, Nick, is frankly overrated. People know we have a baseball team in Kansas City. It's been here for four decades. We have a football team. I think depending on exposure in one game or one event for some sort of public reaction may be a bit overblown.
Yeah, the hope for mission was to expand the national consciousness
yes.
beyond barbecue to show we got a skyline, we've got some great art museums.
People
we've
know
got
we
some
have
real
a skyline. We've got an art museum.
You wouldn't be too
that.
Sure about that, Dave.
True.
Believe me, a lot of people think there are still cattle roaming the streets.
Yeah. The fans that were out there Monday night booing Robinson Cano did more for the city than anything else. Now, you may say some of that's negative. There may be people around the country think, what's wrong with those boorish heartlanders? I don't know. I mean, if these were Philadelphia fans, people would say, oh, look at these great Phillies fans and the way they treated Robinson Cano.
Yes.
That's
Philly,
what got
Philly,
the attention.
In Philly, they booed Santa Claus, right?
Right.
But
that got
about
a lot
the people
of attention.
Who actually came here? Were they really a national audience who actually came to Kansas City? Or were they people who would be, was it a regional draw? People would come in from, say, Iowa and Nebraska, by and large?
It was a regional draw. I've been to a lot of these events. It's my opinion that there were thousands fewer people from out of town that came here than would go typically to Phoenix last year or New York next year.
Okay. Chris?
I just would back up what he's saying and disagree a little bit. Some of the people I talked to were from as far away as New York. But you did see an awful lot of the blue in the stadium, which I think was people who had the ties to the Royals because it was more regional. I still think that the economic development people thought they were going to get a lot more out of this than they actually did.
Just piggybacking on something that Kevin Collison said, the Negro League Baseball Museum seemed to get a big boost. The baseball commissioner, Bud Selig, visiting the facility for the first time, and a substantial video piece on the museum and the pregame show on Fox Sports. Was the Negro League Museum the biggest winner in all of this?
We'll find out when the checks come in. I mean, if they manage to raise some money and leverage this into, increasing their endowment there, that'd be terrific. If they get a more close attachment to some of the big league players. I haven't heard anything yet, but they certainly got the exposure more so than any other organization in town.
Do you think they were the biggest winner?
Well, they might have been. They have tremendous help from former players that are very, very close to the museum, and there's a lot of money there, and those people know the right people. I think it's a management issue with the museum. The things I hear around town is if they get it right, get connected with the right people, this thing's going to survive and do very, very well in the long term. But, we need to make sure we're doing everything we can here in Kansas City on behalf of that museum and not just count on people seeing it from out of town bailing us out.
Last week on the program, I said the $60 million boost there was going to be to the local economy based on that. How did they actually figure out those figures, Kevin?
Oh, it's the old multiplier effect, et cetera. I did talk to a professor from Webster University who took a look at what happened in Detroit a few years ago when they predicted a $60 million, and he said it really looked like it came out to around $30, $35 million. So you take all these things with a grain of salt. Again, I think the woof was not getting some great national images of the city.
Can I just say quickly that Bob Llewellyn was a former city councilman who passed away here about a year ago, and he and I used to talk all the time about taxpayer subsidies for Kemper Arena or for the stadiums. And he used to make the point repeatedly that sometimes it's just good to have things because it's good to have things. And we talk about the economic impact or how the nation saw Kansas City. there is an element of having the All-Star Game that's fun for a city to have, and we should take it as that and not try to put a price tag on it or what did it mean for us going forward or who won or who lost.
It's quality of life.
It was great having it in town. A great diversion for a community in a very hot, very dry summer. And we should at least take a little bit of credit for that, in my view.
Yeah, I'm not an economist in any way. I always think these numbers are low. Do we count the Royals as part of the local economy? I mean, they had 40-some thousand people out there 3 days in a row at, what, $125 a ticket? Now, they don't keep all of that. It goes into Major League Baseball Central Fund. But I find it hard to believe that the Royals themselves, aren't going to make somewhere between $10 and $20 million off this All-Star game. Their attendance is up $4,500 a game this year because people bought tickets just to get into the All-Star game. So if we want to talk about you know, what it's done for the local economy, mostly it's done a lot for David Glass. He's going to cash in and make a lot of money, but he does have a lot of jobs. It did employ a lot of people, and it's clearly churning more money in our economy. I sometimes think these numbers are low.
But I think about it, is it just offsetting money that was going elsewhere? The Haynes family was at Mr. Giro's on 135th Street. In Johnson County, and they say, we'd be glad when this All-Star game is over. We haven't had any business all week long. I mean, nobody was going there because they were all downtown.
One place
we've talked about that before. At political conventions, you hear that all the time. Everybody thinks it's a big windfall for the local people who sponsor it. As it turns out, the restaurants go empty because people have other things to do, and there were organized activities that a lot of the All-Star fans were going to that probably put a dent into the budgets of some of the restaurants in the area.
So people like the you mentioned the fun factor. It is fun for a city, and that has started this, ignited this feeling, we like these kinds of events. So we have heard on radio, sports shows, now calling for a resurrection of the conversation over a rolling roof at the Truman Sports Complex. Do they now think the show's Kansas City can now host a Super Bowl, Kevin?
I have not heard that on my show.
Of course not.
The thing we talk about is I'll make this bold statement. I'll guarantee you the next All-Star game in Kansas City will be downtown at a brand new baseball stadium. That's the next one we will have.
At a downtown baseball stadium?
Baseball-only stadium downtown.
What year is that going to be, Kevin?
I don't think it's going to be as long as you think. I think you'll be amazed how obsolete Kauffman Stadium becomes now that the All-Star game is gone.
Why is that?
They're going to be turning around asking for more money for that stadium here in about 5 to 7 years, and the conversation will begin. And I'm also hopeful the Glass family will sell this baseball team to a local owner, maybe the guys at Cerner or somebody that's locally rooted, and if the Cerner guys had this team, the first thing they would do is talk about
building. But I thought Mr. Glass was making it very clear, even in the last week, that he had no plans whatsoever to sell that team.
Wouldn't you if you were trying to maximize what you could sell it for?
Okay.
I'm with Kevin on the downtown ballpark, but I do think it's going to have to involve a change of ownership of the team. Yep. To be honest with you, if there was a more progressive owner a few years ago, we would have a downtown ballpark right now. People were primed and ready to go. It was David Glass that finally threw the cold water on the effort. But I do think it's not 25 years from now, that lease is not going to expire with the Royals playing out at Truman Sports Complex. I hope I'm around 25 years from now to prove that out.
And I just have to disagree if I can. First of all, there is an ironclad lease. Second, the idea of asking taxpayers for any significant money for a new baseball and, let's face it, a new football stadium if it comes to pass is extraordinarily remote in my view. Minnesota just approved a new football stadium for downtown, $975 million for that stadium. To ask taxpayers to bear any part of that, particularly in Jackson County when they're facing a $2 billion bill on sewers, I think the chances of that are extraordinarily remote.
Now, they are today.
25, 30 years from now, when all of us have gone on to whatever reward awaits us on the other side, then maybe that would be 30 years. Well, for me, anyway.
When was the vote that just passed? 6 years ago? 5 years ago?
Right. Yeah.
Okay, look how the economy and everything has turned in 5 years. We went from an appetite of, sure, we will hand you at a 10-to-1 ratio, we will hand you $225 million, Mr. Glass, if you put in only $25 million. Nobody would go for that today. No chance this thing would vote and pass today. If the Cerner people bought the team, they just bought, they built their own with private money, $250 million soccer stadium.
That was fueled by the sales taxes coming out of the Village West. The Cerner Pope didn't have any cash in that deal.
No cash in that deal.
Right.
Okay, well, you maybe know better than I do.
I'd
like to know where
the
money is coming from.
The money
I know all about
Village
the tax
West.
Breaks and the star bonds.
It's a star
Those are outstanding,
deal.
And that's all based on their revenue over the years for bringing a business.
No,
I understand, but that's not taxing me, right?
No, it's taxing
I'm not
the people
being
who are
taxed
buying
to build that stadium.
No, it's a great deal for Cerner, but there's a big myth out there that they bought that stadium.
We can bring you on again, and we can talk about these things.
Listen, let me
bring up one other thing. We have some other stories we want to talk about. Let me just ask, as we finish up this conversation, because we've talked about Super Bowls, but last week we had Rick Hughes, the head of the Visitors Association, also talking about the Republican National Committee, key representatives here, also during the All-Star Game, looking potentially at a Republican National Convention for Kansas City. But I thought we didn't have enough hotel space.
We seriously lack enough hotel rooms. I'm going to both conventions this year, and Charlotte has an enormous difficulty in providing rooms for the attendees. Kansas City has to make major improvements if it hopes to.
And I'm getting into Dave's territory here. Politically, they put conventions in places they try to influence the vote. Kansas is not in play, and Missouri is increasingly not in play.
More to your point, Nick, about using the All-Star Game, clearly they brought in a lot of people who are convention planners for all kinds of events just to show them how Kansas City can function when it is in the spotlight with a huge event, hoping to lead to future convention sales.
And we've not heard of anything specifically, though, I think that would come out of this.
No. Not yet. These are convention planners who will then go home and make the decision.
Yes, And you're willing to stay on with us as we talk about some other headlines,
Kevin. I'm real quiet, but I'll stay.
No, I'm thoroughly enjoying you. I'm thoroughly enjoying you. Okay.